making you the 2018 Women's Golf Heart of America Athletic Conference champions, statesmen of William Penn, and they're preparing for a national trip down to Florida next week. So before they go down, we wanted to make sure we talk to them. So we're going to talk really loud when we're in this, our huge gym, huge gym. The fans are on, sort of thing, but it sounds like we're yelling because we really are yelling. I want to present everybody. We're going to go right to left since the coach has said really far away from me here. So everybody's name right. We've got Lynn Larson, Brooke Fletcher, Brittany Evans, Megan Rhodes, Alexis Guimarães, Elise Warren, Victoria Grasso, Coach Victoria Grasso, Coach Dylan Detweiler, and Coach Chris Pearson. That was pretty good. Okay, we can stop right now, right? That was a hard part for me. Okay, Coach, we're going to talk to you first. Taking over a program that has had great success for the last 4 years, been part of a lot of that success, but talk about how great it is to put your own stamp on here and continue the straight year now that 5 years going to nationals. Talk about this year a little bit.
Oh, yeah, I mean, the transition, I think, went really smooth because, you know, I've been around for the last 2 years, know all these girls quite well. Came in when Elise, Megan, and Lee were freshmen, Brooke was a sophomore, got that first year, and then obviously Alexis and Brick came in last year. So, you know, I think the transition went really well. It was just kind of a matter of how we were going to do as a team. We knew the talent we had, obviously with everyone coming back, so it was just more of how were we going to do it. Had that expectation, expected it, and we just went out and played. As far as changing anything great, nothing, I don't think any drastic changes happened. It was just more of the adjustment of the new face as the head coach. But, you know, everybody adjusted really well, and obviously we had some pretty good success with it.
Definitely. You go, we have a lot of players, so I'm talking, try to talk to all of you. I'm sorry if broke information. I might actually ask you questions. Elise, first off, though, actually, Elise and Megan as co-players of the year from the Heart, but we'll go left to right. Elise, talk about, going back to the Nationals. You guys taking care of business, came in as the favorites, and put everybody away early. Now, what's the expectation going into the next week on the court?
It's really nice to continue the streak, and we did it pretty confidently, I would say. We were all very excited to get it done and get back to Florida, where we sort of left quite a few strokes out there, so I think the three of us who played, like, we want to get back there and sort of redeem ourselves a little bit. I obviously didn't know if I was going to be able to play, so personally it was nice to be able to play and play pretty well. And I was just really, really happy that the whole team played well. Many months before we went to the national tournament this season, so it's been a really, really great season so far.
Okay. Talk about, you were injured there for a little bit, and everybody stepped up and made it happen.
Yeah, I didn't know if I was going to be able to play.
Exactly. It's like, got no spot for you.
Yeah.
Talk about being out, and just having to be, I guess, as a spectator there, and cheering on the team and knowing that you guys got this. But again, it was just more preparation for conference and everything, but being in a different role, I guess.
It was honestly really nice. Like, I obviously initially...
You want more time off.
Yeah, initially.
Yeah. I don't know.
I was obviously really disappointed, but I just got past that pretty quick, and I really, really enjoyed watching the girls play and play so well. And they obviously broke the 300 barrier, which we've been trying to do for the last couple of years, and it just all came together, and it was really exciting to watch it. Honestly, that's going to be like one of the highlights of my career, and I didn't even play. So honestly, yeah, that was pretty cool. And it just gave me even more confidence that we could do it. Like, no matter who was playing, we have six girls in the air, and on any given day we can beat anyone. So that just sort of solidified it for me.
Okay. changes maybe you made this year to continue to improve and put yourself in that position?
Yeah, I mean, I started last spring showing some scores that I knew would help me this year. And when I came back this year after practicing all summer, I knew that I wanted to make an impact because I didn't know if I was going to be here for 3 or 4 years. But now I get to play next year while I'm doing my master's, which is awesome. And I didn't want to leave this team after how well we were doing this year and like realizing how much I do love the sport and love my team. I didn't want to leave. So I guess just improvements I showed this year and like how team oriented we were and how we were supporting each other really showed that I wanted to be here, and it was just, I guess, an added bonus that I was doing so well and like our team was shooting scores that were awesome. I didn't know that I had it in me, but after being so committed this past summer and then this whole year, I just, it showed that.
However you want to go by, talk about, again, you know, Nationals, another trip, going down there, and you guys, knowing you can play with all this, yeah, you broke 300 now at the point, Penn, 16th in the nation, you guys are going to be favorites in your pairing, all that stuff. Again, expectations for next week. What do you think you guys are capable of doing, and what do you want to do? I know it's hard to say, here's our goal, is to do this. You just want to play well and hopefully all the chips fall, but what are you guys looking to do next week?
I think expectations are probably the highest for us and our team. We really just want to go down and improve where we belong. I think this time, this year, getting actually pushed up to actually managed to do that in the last month or so. It's really proven to us that we are worth more than what we were getting respectful for a while, and getting that right before national can really give you a good push to go down and say we want to make an impact. And I mean, we're not expecting to go down and just, you know, everybody shoot under par, be awesome, but I mean, we're realistic, but it's still, we're going down definitely knowing that we can do something really great. And I'm personally super excited about it. Last year we went down for the first time. It was a little bit nerve-wracking, I suppose, but it was awesome. And then we luckily got to play the Champions course, so we've seen it, or some of us have seen it, feeling pretty good about it. And going down again and just really give it everything, I think that's an amazing achievement we're getting. And my own goal for the team is just to go down and not leave anything out there, whatever that means for us.
All right, bro. You're the senior, dude, right? Yeah, the lone senior of the group, so I talked to you. Been part of four conference title teams, and this is old hat for everybody. Everybody's been part of at least two now. But you know, talk about just capping your career with, you know, knowing that you guys won another conference title, another national tournament where you know, you guys are the program, especially the women's program on campus, that everybody strives to be. So just being part of that, knowing that, you know, you've left quite a legacy.
Yeah, coming here as a freshman, like I said, I really know what to expect in college ball. And when I first started here, it was really competitive, but I even feel like going through each year, it got more competitive each year. And even now, I'd probably say this year, we've been playing our best, I'd say, and even the competition between us all is so close. And it's something that I'd say, if I wouldn't have started my freshman year with it being so competitive, I don't know if I would have gotten that point where I would have been improving. But all these players have definitely had an impact on everything we've done, and all the players who put all their hard work together, and even the players from 1 to 13 on our team, they've all grown and made a lot of effort, and they've all grown. And I've heard even some of the freshmen now, that they've already grown and improved, and it's just something I think we need to see, and I think we all my game as a freshman, I'm shooting horrible scores. I never thought I would shoot again.
You wouldn't want to say the numbers, right?
Yeah. And then now, all of a sudden, I started shooting back to my normal. Anybody can do it, honestly. It's about a clear line. And I know each person on this team can even improve on what they've already done. And they've even broken their own individual record as players this year. So I just
right? Pretty. Again, everybody that's sitting here has never lost a conference title, including yourself. So, and it's just like, what's the big deal? How is this so difficult? That's the guys that you have a 44-year absence from winning, but so they're finally up there with you guys too. But talk about as the youngsters, and Alexis, we'll get to you in a second, but as the youngsters and you guys continue to carry the torch after the world's career is over and you guys are stepping into a bigger role, but you know, pressure, not pressure, going into nationals, knowing that you guys are all really good players. You all have the opportunity to shoot both 70s. Did that help going into nationals? Less pressure? I know I asked a whole bunch of things here. Basically, like a final question, sorry, is going into nationals, do you feel any pressure? Like, knowing that you guys are such a solid team, you know, to know, per se, it's studs. I'm not going to go over the biggest part of all studs, but any pressure?
I would say no, because we all know that we have a triple back, and it lightens that fear I have to play well. Because we all know that we're all playing well. Like, when Elise got hurt, we all stepped up in that tournament and broke the school record, and that showed right there that we all know play well. We go out there and do what we need to do. We don't need to put that pressure on ourselves. We've been doing it and show up.
Yeah. All right. Alexis stepped up big time. I don't know if the correlation could be once Elise went out, all of a sudden, hey, guess what? We can now shoot 300. That's my joke on the golf side. I always say once I stepped out of the coaching role in golf, then guess what? Now the women are winning. Kind of, well, I guess they were winning before that, but now the guys all of a sudden are winning kind of titles. Get this guy out, and so obviously get Elise out of the picture, and then he's been so much better. So. But no, talk about your spring and just, you know, how successful you have been and, you know, just building towards, you know, another national tournament appearance.
Spring was crazy. I did not really expect that much. My mentality going to every season is just doing whatever I can for the team, whether that's cheering them on, pushing them to practice, and if I do end up playing with my heart, just putting it all out there. And when Elise got hurt, it was a little scary. It was like 20 minutes before the tee time. Alexis, you're going in. Okay. And at that point, I thought, all I can do is just put it all out there. I thought of my teammates, both at that tournament and the ones that were here. Just play for your team, put it all out there, and just enjoy the moment. Not really let it get here.
All right, we got two assistant coaches here that I'll only ask one of them. Flip a coin. Working with the legend, which is Chris Pearson, but I don't know
that's a legend.
and Dylan, you've been a part of several conference titles, and before you step in, and guess what? We keep on winning. So let's talk about, you know, how special this team has been this year, and especially breaking that 300 goal that, I mean, all the teams have been so close to doing. But just recap this year and, you know, going into next week and another chance to fight for a national title.
This team is definitely special. I mean, we had a few hiccups in the fall. We were playing as well as we were the spring before, so I think that was kind of getting to us a little bit. So this spring has been even more exciting because of that. We kind of finished off the fall well, shot some good scores, then right away in the spring kicked in the gear. I think, honestly, a lot of teams have been complaining about the weather. They haven't been able to get outside or practice. We have awesome facilities here, so we were able to do it all. We got the pack, really worked on our short game, worked on things like that, and I think that's where the shots are dropping. So all their hard work and dedication and the extra time and effort that they put in to practice and preparing really, really helped. So yeah, breaking that 300 barrier, I really think it came down to short game. We've always been a one team.
All right, Coach. Put a little bow on this whole interview here that we've got. Talk about next week and, you know, just the fun of being able to go back.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, you got six great players here. We got seven others that have pushed these six to the level that we're at and always do, and that's kind of our focus. You know, it doesn't matter if you're playing that number one or that number 13, if you're not pushing everybody in front of you, then no one's getting better. And they did that. I mean, really showed, I mean, in the spring, just like Coach Detweiler said, being inside and not complaining about the weather, because everybody knows the weather in the spring is not great. And we have a 309 average. I mean, that's pretty incredible to think about, and just testing it to what these girls did. And, you know, that's kind of what we say. It doesn't matter what's thrown our way. We deal with it, we play, and we go. I mean, Baker has been an interesting place for us. You know, 20 minutes before the conference preview, Alexis gets in. The night before, a lot of people don't know, we didn't know if she was going to go, so Alexis was sitting there again, like, what's going on with this place? But, you know, we handled it, and we shot some really good scores. And, you know, the spring has been awesome. It's been kind of a dream season, obviously, for a first-time head coach. And, you know, it's a lot to live up to, but I think we can do it, and we can continue the success. Next week, you know, we just got to embrace and enjoy the moment. Anytime you're at this level, nationals, state, whatever, conference, you just got to enjoy it, because you got to realize, you know, there's 30 teams down there out of, how many are?
180.
You know, we're one of those 30 teams that got invited to go, qualified to go. So we just got to enjoy it, not let our highs be too high and our lows be too low, and just focus on what we need to do. And as long as we do that, it'll work out. I have 100% confidence that it'll just work out. It's going to be fun. Golf Stat obviously will have some scoring, I believe, so all you fans out there need to follow along. Obviously, our Twitter is very popular. We update that every three holes, try to. Sometimes it gets a little difficult, but, you know, we do our best so everyone can follow along. Other than that, you know, just we're going to enjoy it.
Yeah. All right. Congratulations, ladies and coaches. Had a great season. We'll definitely be keeping track of you. Nick's going to be down there too, and he did a great job tweeting out from the WPU Athletics account. So there'll be all sorts of information out there, and hopefully the live scoring going better this week. Wasn't that, that's a hot spot for all of that. But yeah, next Tuesday through Friday, PGA National Golf Course, Palm Beach Gardens, Florida. Right? Okay. Palm Beach Gardens,